everybody. We aren't starting the service yet, but I just wanted to see if the sound is working. So if you could comment below if the sound is working or if there's anything else we should try. We'll start in about 5 more minutes.
Well, good morning, and welcome to worship on this third Sunday of Lent. What an unusual situation for us to worship in this way. It was a difficult decision for us to cancel worship and church activities through March 27th, and I can say already this morning that we really miss you being here. But we have done this in the interest of public health, and we will not only not be holding Sunday worship, we won't hold Wednesday or any of our other activities. However, Wednesday night, we will have our Lenten worship service online. We'll also be working to find other ways to stay connected throughout these 2 weeks. So today we have 4 of our staff people here to lead worship. Myself, Pastor Dave, we have Shannon, our music and worship director, and we have Madeline Cacciatore, who is our senior choir, adult choir, and our youth choir director. So thank you to them for being here today. As I said, excuse me, all of our activities are canceled through March 27th. The Wings dinner that was scheduled for March 29th, we've already decided to postpone that. We encourage you during this time, as Dave and I will be reaching out to people, we encourage you to reach out to people that you know might be alone or homebound during this time. You know, to make a phone call, send a card, or send a text message. We also have had a couple of people from our congregation already volunteer that if you are someone who is in that vulnerable category and don't feel comfortable going to the grocery store and you need something, to please call the church and we will be in touch with those volunteers who would pick up what you needed and deliver it to your home. So please call the church if you know someone in need of that. Now, while we won't be here taking an offering this morning, we do encourage you to give online if you aren't already, or also to mail your offering to the church so that the ministries of our church can continue. During this time, the pastors are available for pastoral care. Most of our pastoral care will be done by phone. However, please know that if there is a pastoral emergency, please contact Pastor Kathy or Pastor Dave because we are available for that. Today you will find if you have a couple of different devices that you're using, you can use your Facebook Live to hear what we're saying, and the PowerPoint for all of worship is on our church website so that you would be able to follow along if you would like and to sing the hymns with us. In our prayers this week, we have added several people. We have added Paul Nelson, who is recovering from surgery. We have added the family of Andy Wendinger. Andy died suddenly this past week in Mankato. He is the grandson of Jolene Wendinger and the brother of Emily Gearing, and he has other family members here. So please hold all of them in your prayers. We also continue to pray for the family of Maxon Weber. Maxon's funeral was here on Tuesday. We pray for the family of Howard Olson, who passed away on Saturday. Howard is the husband of Lovenel, many of you know them, and the father of Valerie Ofterheide. We continue to pray for all of those on our prayer list and for all that is going on in our world today. And so with that, we will begin worship. And we begin with the gathering hymn. And if you're following the PowerPoint, it is Come to Me, All Pilgrims Thirsty. If you happen to have a hymnal at home, it is hymn number 777.
Come to me, all pilgrims thirsty. The water I will give. If you knew what gift I offer, you would come to me and live. Jesus, living fountain, give us water from your well. Give us gracious gift to offer. There is joy no tongue can tell. Come to me while travels waiting, find refreshment in this place. Come receive the gift I offer, turn to me and seek my face. Jesus, living fountain, give us water from your well. In our gracious gift you offer, there is joy no tongue can tell. Come to me, repentant sinners, leave behind your guilt and shame. Come and know divine compassion, turn to me, I call your name. Jesus, living fountain, give us water from your well. In the gracious gift you offer, there is joy no tongue can tell.
We continue with the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. We take a moment for reflection. Gracious God, have mercy on us.
We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent.
In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us, even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together in Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that God may live in your hearts through faith. Amen.
Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And also with you. We'll join in our Kyrie.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Amen.
Let's join in our prayer of the day. Merciful God, the fountain of living water, you quench our thirst and wash away our sin. Give us this water always. Bring us to drink from the well that flows with the beauty of your truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We'll continue with our readings. The first reading for today comes from the book of Romans, the 5th chapter. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Much more surely then, now that we have been justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more surely, having been reconciled, will we be saved by his life. But more than that, we even boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. We'll join in singing our gospel acclamation. Let your steadfast love come to us, O Lord. Save us as you promised, we will trust your word. The Holy Gospel according to John, the 4th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus came to a Samaritan city called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired out by his journey, was sitting by the well. It was about noon. A Samaritan woman came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone to the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How is it that you, a Jewish person, ask a drink of me, a woman of Samaria?" Jewish people did not share things in common with Samaritans. Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you have no bucket, and this well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our ancestor Jacob, who gave us this well, and with his sons and his flock drank from it?" Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But those who drink of the water that I will give them will never be thirsty. The water that I give will become in them a spring of water gushing up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water, so that I may never be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water." Jesus said to her, "Go call your husband and come back." The woman answered him, "I have no husband." And Jesus said to her, "You're right in saying I have no husband, for you have had 5 husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman said to him, "Sir, I see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on the mountain, but you say that the place where people must worship is in Jerusalem." Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when we will worship the Father neither on the mountain or in Jerusalem. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, and is now here, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father seeks such as these to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth." The woman said to him, "I know that the Messiah is coming, who is called the Christ. When he comes, he will proclaim all things to us." Jesus said to her, "I am he, the one who is speaking to you." Just then his disciples came. They were astonished that he was speaking with a woman, but no one said, "What do you want?" or "Why are you speaking with her?" Then the woman left her water jar and went back to the city. She said to the people, "Come and see a man who told me everything I have ever done. He cannot be the Messiah, can he?" They left the city and were on their way to him. Many Samaritans from that city believed in him because of the woman's testimony. "He told me everything I have ever done." So when the Samaritans came to him, they asked him to stay with them, and he stayed there for 2 days. And many more believed because of his word. They said to the woman, "It's no longer because of what you said that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated for those in the room. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Last week, we had my favorite piece of scripture. We also had one of Pastor Kathy's favorite pieces of scripture. We talked a lot about Psalm 121 and how it gives us strength, it gives us hope, gives us the light of God in our lives, helps us to see the blessings. And we also had John 3:1-17, contains one of the most famous pieces of scripture, John 3:16. But we sometimes forget the context of that. Most of us know that passage. We know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, so that whosoever believes in him may live even though they die. We know that. We've heard it 1,000 times. But when we put it into context, it changes how we read this story. See, that passage comes to us from Jesus as he's talking to Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a leader in the synagogue. He was a religious scholar, and he came to Jesus by night. He didn't want anybody to know he was talking to this heretical guy who's preaching all these weird things. But he recognized that Jesus was doing something, and he wanted to learn. So Nicodemus goes to Jesus, and he does his best to understand. Now, he's a religious scholar. He knows the Hebrew Bible. He knows all of these things. He's got this. But Jesus can't make it work. Jesus can't explain it to him. He literally needs Jesus to give him John 3:16 so he can get a glimpse into what the kingdom of God is like. Imagine that, a religious leader with a thick skull. None of us would know at all what that's like. So, right after that story, Jesus begins traveling, and he gets to this city, Sychar, which is a Samaritan city. He's not supposed to be here. He shouldn't be here. Jewish people and Samaritans hated each other. They could not get along. They could not care for one another. And then Jesus ends up at the well. At this time, only women would go to the well. That was the place where women would gather. Jesus isn't supposed to be there. And while he's there, there's a woman there. At this time, a man and a woman who weren't married or weren't from the same family would not spend time together or talk to each other without a chaperone around. He's not supposed to be talking to this woman. He's in the wrong city. He's at the place he's not supposed to be, and he's talking to someone he shouldn't be talking to. So, in the context of this story, Nicodemus, the religious leader, gets it explained to him word for word and still struggles to make sense of it. But this woman who shouldn't understand the idea of Messiah in the context of the story, she gets it. And what does she do? She leaves her water jar behind. She came to get water, but she leaves it behind because she knows the importance here. She knows that she's found something better than water. She found something that brings hope and life into her life. We see this story and we hear the words of Jesus, and some people often think that Jesus is being judgmental about this woman. He has that comment of, you've had 5 husbands, and now you have one who isn't your husband. That's not Jesus being judgmental here. That's Jesus literally just telling this woman that he knows her, that he cares about her, that he wants her to live in happiness and in love. It's not a judgment. It's Jesus proving who he is, helping him make sense of who this woman is, and showing us who has the right to share the gospel. This woman goes into town, shares the gospel, and a ton of people believe because of her, and they run out to the well, and it changes this town. It changes everything. One of the first people who preached the gospel in the Gospel of John is a Samaritan woman who, according to the times, shouldn't be talking to this guy. But she's the one who gets it. She met Jesus at the well. She talked with him, and she learned. We all have one of those stories of meeting Jesus at the well. Some of us, it may have happened when we were 70 years old, when we first started thinking about how God influenced our lives. Some of us, it could have been when we were 5 years old, and our grandpa was sitting behind us making sure we paid attention in church. We all have those well moments. And I want us to think about how we can share that now. It's a little awkward to talk about this because right now I'm preaching to these three and my cell phone, and it feels very strange. But think about that. That phone is a well. When you share a video like this, people who aren't in our church will see it. People will get a chance to worship with us. They'll get to join in this community. When you give someone a phone call just to say, hey, how are you doing? Can I do anything for you? Or just to talk and to take their mind off of a stressful situation. When you send them a card or a text or an email or a Snapchat or any number of things. This modern world has a lot of places where we can meet at the well. So, I want to encourage you. Nope, that's not the word I want to use. I'm going to assign you homework. I'm not encouraging you, this is what you need to do this week. I want you to get in touch with 5 people. Give them a call. Shoot them a text. Facebook them, Snapchat them, whatever. Ask them how they're doing. See if there's anything you can do for them. Ask if you can pray for them. Ask if you can pray with them. This is a stressful time, but we know who our God is. We know what we're here to do. We're here to share the gospel and to care for everyone around us. So this week, 5 people, reach out. Show them you care. Show them the love of God that is alive and well in you. Let's bring some hope and joy into a world that sometimes feels a little dark. Let's remember that Nicodemus eventually got it. This woman at the well eventually got it. The disciples eventually got it. Your pastors eventually got it, we think. Take this as an opportunity to share the love of God with all the modern technology that we have. Meet some people at the well and share the love of God with them. Let's pray. Holy God, sometimes this world terrifies us. Sometimes we don't know what's going on. But we trust that if we're laughing, you're laughing with us. If we're crying, you're right there beside us crying with us. Help us to see your love and light and hope in this world. And help us to bring that to the people around us. Whether they're friends, family, enemies, anyone. Help us to be your light bearers for the world. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's join in our hymn of the day, which is You Are Mine. So you can find the lyrics on the PowerPoint online, or if you do have a hymnal, number 581, or you can just Google for the lyrics.
You as my joy.
With the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. For the prayers today, we will sing the response first, and then we will sing the same response after each petition. God of living water, send your church beyond boundaries to proclaim your grace. May its witness be a source of refreshment for thirsty souls. Strengthen our voices that all people can know and believe that Jesus is truly the Savior of the Lord. Lord, in your mercy. God of living water, open the hearts of leaders and authorities that they hear the cries of the suffering and act with compassion toward them. We pray for our leaders, President Trump, Governor Waltz, our senators and representatives. Give them wisdom in all things. Lord, in your mercy.
Oh, Lord, hear my prayer.
God of living water, mend the hearts of those who grieve broken relationships. Draw near to all who are ill, especially Bailey, Russ, Carl, Marilyn, Sharon, Joyce, Roger, Dave, Paul, Brandon, Joanne, Tom, Sandy, Maxine, Sharon, Wally, Darla, Con, and Paul. Comfort those who grieve, especially the family of Andy Wenninger, the family of Max and Weber, and the family of Howard Olson. Assure those questioning your presence in the midst of doubt or suffering. Lord, in your mercy.
Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord. Prayer. Oh.
God of living water, come to our aid as the coronavirus spreads globally. Heal those who are sick. Support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Grant us your spirit of love and self-discipline so that we may come together, working to control and eliminate the coronavirus. Make us vigilant, attentive, and proactive in the eradication of all diseases that create suffering. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear my prayer.
God of living water, strengthen and encourage those in public health services and in the medical profession who commit themselves to caring for the sick and their families. Inspire, give insight and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine. Sustain all workers and business owners who suffer loss of livelihood due to shutdowns, quarantines, closed borders, and other restrictions. Protect and guard all those who must travel. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and in the midst of turmoil, give us hope and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear my prayer.
God of living water, renew us in the promises of baptism. Join us together in worship, fellowship, and sharing your good news, even as we do not meet in person. Embolden us to serve others today and every day. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, hear my prayer.
And together we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Now and forever. Amen. And receive this blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.